Australian Woodchop and the Great Australian Muster. This is the International Relays coming up. Australia versus New Zealand versus the United States of America. Huge crowd in. And here come the Australians, Greg.
Yes, Greg. 40-odd thousand people in the stands tonight, and they're certainly welcoming the Australian team in, and what a great lineup there.
Yes, Australia have a great team. New Zealand and the United States are their competition.
People coming to their feet now, Greg, for the national anthem.
Yes, the national anthem's about to be sung as the Australians get to their positions and prepare for what is going to be a fabulous three-test series with the three countries. And this is the international relay.
The battle's on again. And of course we have the Americans. And we can't disregard them, but there's no mistake about who the enemy is.
Once you put that green single in Australia, it seems to blow them up the same as it does with us, you know.
We have a stronger team this year. We should be much better. Will we win? I don't know. Will we do better? Yes, we will.
None of us can make any mistakes. We've got to support each other. And hopefully, when the end result comes up, Shane Guernsey will be up front.
The Aussies really get behind their team, and I think it's probably like a rugby game. A rugby team is playing at their home stadium. I think it's a little bit of an advantage, but we're going to be really focused and get out there and do our best.
The national anthem being sung, Australians stand to attention.
Robert Sipp himself in action from West Australia.
Australia versus New Zealand versus the United States of America. The crowd's going to love this.
They certainly will. A series of three races, Greg. Two to be conducted in the main arena and the last one in the Woodchop Stadium.
Seven disciplines, Keith.
Yes, underhand to standing block, then to single-handed soaring, double-handed soaring, underhand, and to finish the race, a standing block.
There's the New Zealand side, David Bolstead and Jason Winyon, a couple of world champs managed by John McKenzie.
Great team, very strong team, New Zealand.
And the United States, outsiders in this, Melbourne Lentz is the captain, he'll start off. They're managed by Jim Taylor.
And of course the Americans are cutting our hardwood. They're finding a little bit of difficulty with the hardwood that we cut here.
All right, we're just about to start. And away they go.
Yes, in the underhand, the first event, 325 millimeter, the diameter of the log, it is silver top ash, a New South Wales hardwood that comes from near the Victoria border.
Harold Winkle there for Australia, cutting through the wood.
Just turned and very strong opposition there from New Zealand.
David Bolstead it is for the Kiwis as Harold Winkle continues through, and there's the American Melbourne Lentz. So Australia and New Zealand, Ollie.
Just about off together there, Greg, and now to the standing block.
Yeah, the standing block, and representing Australia, Matthew Gurr, Jason Winyon for New Zealand, and we will see the American Arden Koga Jr.
Matthew Gurr, very, very fine country. He's a world champion tree feller and a very, very good action.
They are going head-to-head at the moment. There's not much between the Aussies and the New Zealanders. Gurr and Winyon turning together there.
Team captain there, Gary Smith, calling to Matthew Gurr.
Now, what would he be doing?
He's giving him advice when to drive the log, and now he's coming in with his cutter.
All right, we're getting set for the next changeover to the single-handed saw. And away go the Kiwis. This is Dion Lane, and the Aussies away. Phil Campbell it is for Australia. The USA are lagging behind.
Yes, the Australians are cutting very well the saw. Dion Lane there, very strong New Zealand. A little bit of a problem there. The saw buckled. Can be quite dangerous if that happens.
So maybe the Aussies might kick away here.
Well, they have a chance. And the saw buckled again with New Zealand.
All right.
There's a problem there, Greg.
So Phil Campbell's in front here.
Oh, yes. And, of course, the Australians away into the double-handed sawing now.
This is Stephen Kirk and Justin Beckett representing Australia. And Alan Salter and Warren Riddle for New Zealand. And by gee, they got through that with the Aussies.
They certainly did. And there's the American team still on the single-handed sawing. They're coming very well.
Back to the underhand. Lawrence O'Toole now for Australia. He's getting through it quickly.
Great action of the son of that wonderful champion, Jack O'Toole. Lawrence O'Toole, a champion in his own right.
Chasing him is Ivan Thomas for New Zealand, and the Yanks are trying very, very hard. They've got to get to Matt Bush, who will be representing them here in the underhand.
Now, new couple of hits in the third break, with Australia around first, but New Zealand right on the heels. Who'll come off here first?
Lawrence O'Toole and Ivan Thomas. There's Ivan going through the wood and getting ready is Terry Honig there for the New Zealanders, and away they go.
Now this is the final block. Standing block for both teams.
Dale Beams, the Tasmanian for Australia, and Terry Honig from New Zealand. It's Australia versus New Zealand. This is better than a Blenders Lake Cup.
Australia around to the back now, New Zealand around.
Australia in front through Dale Beams. Dale Beams, only a few chops left to go for victory. The New Zealanders trying hard through Trevor Honig, and then a mile away to the Yanks. But it is Dale Beams from Tasmania. He's got the lead. He hasn't got long to go. Terry Honig's trying very, very hard.
Right on his heels. Every Australia.
The Australians through, they win the first test. Dale Beams getting rid of the wood, and there goes the New Zealanders. Terry Honig in second spot will wait for the USA team. This is
America just striking a problem with his hardwood, but great sportsman, cutting very, very well, and they must adapt with their axes, different style of grind with the axe. They can cut this hardwood.
Dave Jewett for the United States, trying his best to get through this wood, but it is Dale Beams ahead of Terry Honig, and eventually Dave Jewett will come in third spot. So the Australians, great teamwork.
Wonderful team, and the New Zealanders too, a wonderful team, and not to overlook our Americans there, putting up a brave battle there in this pretty hard wood, as I said before. He'll be driving that down shortly, I think, trying to drive it. No, he's coming up again. There we go.
Australia first, New Zealand second, the United States third. Over 7 seconds to spare there between Australia and New Zealand after the first test here at the Great Australian Woodshop.